Tune into this week's episode of the DevOps Lab, where we have the Xbox team with us talking about application insights. And you should tune in because monitoring is important and getting that full visibility and traceability in your environment is super critical to your DevOps process. So tune in for this week's episode. Welcome back to episode 5 in this series with the Xbox Customer Experiences team. We're going to welcome back Chad Stewart. Welcome, Chad.
Hey, thanks. Good to be back. Good to see you again.
Did you bring your Xbox controller?
Oh, one of 17 I have just sitting in the back here.
All right, I'm ready.
Okay, what are we going to do?
Let's go.
Yeah.
All right, I guess we should probably talk about why we're here today. So we're going to talk about how you guys and the Xbox team use application insights for your end-to-end kind of visibility in your apps.
Yeah, app insights for us has been kind of a game changer in terms of kind of our live site and on-call experiences. So, you know, as you know, when we have a huge swath of services we own. So Xbox customer experiences team, we own like Xbox support, the feedback services, who are like all bug diagnostics, the Xbox Insider program. All of those services are comprised of a bunch of different small microservices, and each one of them can have their own issues, right? Mm-hmm. Maybe someone deploys something that's bad, like they say one in every 5 lines of code has a bug in it or something like that. So as you can imagine, we have a lot of, you know, every week for each one of these services, we have a designated on-call or live site engineer who is kind of responsible to make sure that, you know, if anything goes south, that they can kind of fix whatever issue is going on. Now, I'm going to go ahead and jump into a demo to kind of show you how we're leveraging App Insights.
Awesome.
So what's pulled up here on screen right now is the App Insights for the XFS data service. So the feedback services have a data service. It's just a simple HTTP service. And this is going to be common across all services we have. So like Azure Functions, web services, any VM services we have hosted somewhere, all of them are pumping telemetry into Application Insights because it's kind of the core way that we get in, you know, it's in the name, Application Insights. It's the insights into our application, really. And by default, you know, we're using the more modern net core 3.1 plus tech stack. Some of our stuff is even on like V5, V6 today. It's kind of like, you know, it's always a maintenance to kind of upgrade everything. But by default, if you are using the net core 3.1 plus packs and you're kind of in that framework, you can plug in App Insights to your application pretty easily. Here is an example of the HTTP service that we have. And, you know, the two main views that we're usually using in App Insights are this failures view, which does a really good job at kind of like, you know, there's no errors in here right now. Maybe if I expand to last 30 days, we'll see some exceptions or something. But what it really does is it, like, you know, any exceptions that are getting thrown, any 500s our service might throw, even some, like, you know, you can configure it to show you bad requests if that's the case. Mm-hmm. You can see what it's doing here is it kind of categorizes your exceptions like this. It, you know, looks at the stack trace and it puts them all together. So it gives you a really nice view into your issues. So, you know, here from the last 30 days, we can see there was some kind of 500 happening over here. And like when I click into it, it's got, you know, all of the 500s listed here. And I can jump into one to kind of, you know, look at this end-to-end view to see what went wrong in my service. Let's see, view. So this is kind of like the timeline view, the end-to-end transaction. You can see, you know, we were trying to do something, and then all of a sudden we got an exception. Now, the on-call engineer will see this if they got like an alert for this via Azure monitors or something like that. They'll come in here, they'll, you know, do the appropriate debugging steps, look at logs, whatever. But this is kind of like our core starter debugging place. In addition, we also have this performance tab here. Failures view is most used mostly, you know, for issues. Performance is really good just to give you like insight into the, you know, your service isn't failing, but maybe it's taking a long time. The latency is really high. You know, users are experiencing timeouts or something like that. This performance tab can kind of give you insight into that. You know, over here you can see we've got like our like a distribution of like what our latencies are. You can see what our success rates are, how long on average each one of these requests is taking to our service. And all of this, you know, all of these views and everything sort of come for free just by using the net core, you know, plus framework and saying like, I think on the startup code, there's literally like a like dot add app insights or something, and it's boom, it's automatically connected. So very, very nice for for HTTP services, and Azure Functions actually are very similar. So this is, this is a function app. You know, ignore the name, it's just a processing app for XFS. But if we look at the failures view or the performance view, you can see the request telemetry here. So like these are the Azure Functions. It's broken up the same way. So, you know, it's really nice for our on-call engineer. It doesn't matter if they're looking at an HTTP service or if they're looking at Azure Functions. When they're debugging it, it's the same. The tooling is the same. The function run versus the handler run, they appear the same in the telemetry, which really makes it easy for us to kind of debug those issues. Performance tab is going to look very similar. Now, one of the things that we did that was kind of special to use App Insights is that we not only use App Insights for our HTTP Azure services and our Azure Functions, which kind of come for free, but we've also done some additional work to instrument some of our console apps. So on console, we own the Xbox Insider Hub, where you can join and manage like your flights or your system update ring. And then we've also the report a problem app. So when you're filing a bug on the Xbox console or saying like, you know, I have a problem, the game wouldn't load, something like that, that app is also owned by our team. And we've done some, you know, special instrumentation to those apps to allow them to also pump into to App Insights the same way. So like these views get populated for those console apps as well. So, when we were looking at this Azure function here, you can see we get this really nice, this is probably a bad example. Yeah, but this end-to-end transaction view here, basically when you're using App Insights and you're using it on multiple services, it will add some like diagnostic IDs to your HTTP request and to like the underlying like diagnostic activity, which is part of the .NET core like framework. And like what it does is it strings together this end-to-end transaction view where you can really see start to finish what happened for a user. Now this becomes very useful in our console apps. Here's an example of the report a problem app. So this is the scenario here is a user came in and said, I am filing a bug. You know, they go through the steps and we've instrumented our app. So, you know, we can see here the app launches, we've initialized some stuff and, you know, inside of here, we're getting some user data, we're getting the game data. We're accessing connected storage for whatever this is, doing some status compute and all of this stuff, all of these like internal operations to the app are kind of shown here because we've instrumented them to plug into App Insights and insights nicely. You can see even here, we've got like part of this app's core responsibility is interacting with some underlying stuff to basically start a diagnostic payload. And you can see that's kind of happening here via this like trying to populate capture, mm-hmm. All of these things. Here's where the bundle gets submitted up to our service. And then of course, at the end, we show the user a thank you kind of prompt. Now, where this is, how this is actually getting implemented, here is some of our source code for, you know, the wrappers and stuff that we are actually using to wrap this telemetry. And for anyone who is familiar with Application Insights or have used it before, you'll probably recognize this telemetry client. This is the base telemetry client for all Application Insights. You know, from that client, you can say, start a trace, start an error, add a request telemetry, stuff like that. And, you know, inside of our app, we have these extensions where we can track a request, track a request that has some kind of return type. And what it's really doing is it's starting telemetry, kind of adding a telemetry wrapper, and then calling whatever function it is that is part of our app or whatever. So all of those like internal dependencies our app may have or, special stuff that necessarily isn't an HTTP call, we wrap with this so that in the Application Insights view, it shows up really nicely in that that end-to-end transaction view. You can see here, we've even got some special stuff here for like our HTTP traffic where we're tracking it as a dependency in that view. And this is kind of the magic that's kind of stitching that together. Now we use this in apps. We've also even used this on some VM services. We have a special service that has some very specific VNet requirements where it needs to be connected to a VNet somewhere hidden mm-hmm. away from the world and whatever. Yep. And so it couldn't really be an Azure function, although the responsibility of this service was basically Azure function. It's kind of like a processing app. But we were actually able to reuse kind of this template here that we use for the app. And here's kind of some source for that VM I'm talking about where, you know, with Azure functions, they're triggered by HTTP or a service bus or an event hub. This VM that's running is effectively like we kind of built Azure Functions just to run on this VM sort of. And this is kind of our core message processor, the base processor for all of our all of the processing we're doing on this app. And you can see it really follows that same pattern. So, you know, as we we register the processor, when a message comes in, so like we're on the queue that we're listening to, we're registering some message handler, we're extracting the activity information from Service Bus. So, you know, part of Azure Functions, you know, like I talked, there's like this diagnostic ID, which Application Insights will kind of attach to everything for you. That's kind of what's happening here. We're pulling that ID off of the message, and then we're starting a request off of that telemetry. So basically, the incoming Service Bus message that we just received, we're continuing the activity with this new operation. So basically, the message we got is the parent of the internal operation we're about to perform. And that becomes really great in our telemetry because, we can see those transactions in these views. So this is actually the processing app. You can see each one of our, the processors, which is effectively like an Azure function just on a VM, is mm-hmm. instrumented here kind of as request telemetry. And we get all of the the error handling, the performance tracking, all of that stuff, and all of these views and app insights just kind of get populated by, adding one or two lines to our code that basically wrap some call in, app insights telemetry. And it's, kind of as I mentioned kind of at the top of this, like, it's really been a game changer in kind of like when you have a lot of different technologies and a lot of different services and a lot of different engineers working on stuff, when you're able to kind of like merge together the investigation tools, like specifically like this DevOps piece where like if there's an issue, everybody has like the tool set to understand how to use App Insights. It really makes it easier for different engineers across different pieces of your code base to be able to jump into something that maybe they don't necessarily have the subject matter expertise on. However, they can still debug the issue because, it's all in App Insights. App Insights is kind of like our one-stop shop for anything related to, debugging or investigating our app's health.
And you've hit the nail on the head, like end-to-end app scenario. And when we're deploying stuff in a DevOps mindset, right? And we have the monitoring piece hooked in, it's being able to know when we have an outage, because we're going to have an outage, we're going to have latency. And I think App Insights, you spoke about it, like sometimes you get a failure request to a resource, but not necessarily a system down, right? You might need to scale something out and fix it. Something's hanging. And I think App Insights, it hooks into everything end to end. In the old days of monitoring, you talked about running a lot of these on a VM, right? You're running some functions on a VM. We would monitor the VM and we wouldn't know how far down the stack that issue would be, or is the VM having an issue, right? App Insights pulls all that apart and makes it so much faster to troubleshoot and debug your code if you, have any issues with your infrastructure or anything serverless behind it. So it's a wicked powerful tool. I'm glad you guys are able to find it and like really hook into it and really leverage it. That's really cool.
Yep, exactly.
Cool. Thank you everyone for joining us today. And thank you, Chad, and to the entire Xbox customer experiences team for letting us get some insight into how the Xbox team does DevOps. So thank you everyone for tuning in, and we'll put the link to the series in the show notes, and tune in next time for the DevOps Lab for more awesome DevOps content.